still playing with Lizzy to this day, man. You know, that, what I love is that Scott, he still wants to play, but he doesn't want to go bananas and do, you know, 60, 80 dates a year. And just a few festivals, and it gives me a chance to focus on my solo.
Again, and kind of a blessing there. So Thin Lizzy, you're going to make a new record, but you don't want to release it as Thin Lizzy. Correct? Am I correct in that that's
you are,
developed
you are
into
partly
what?
Correct. I wanted to release it as Thin Lizzy. I wanted to go to the record store and pick up a Thin Lizzy CD or vinyl and turn around the back and it says guitars, Scott Gorham, Damon Johnson. I wanted that more than anything. We had written some great songs that were very Lizzy-esque, you know, and you might say, well, man, how do you write Thin Lizzy songs without Phil Lynott? Mm-hmm. Well, it's not easy. You have to have an incredible lyricist and proper writer in your band, and that's what we have with Ricky Warwick. Ricky's a great writer and so respectful about Phil. Phil was his hero, totally.
And vocally,
it's very similar.
Tough
man.
To find a guy that is so similar to Phil. Well,
definitely
anywhere
that
near
same
there.
Kind
yeah.
of baritone.
Yeah,
he's got
yeah,
that same
not,
baritone
not
in his voice
find.
That's not easy to find. In hindsight, maybe I'm still sort of 50-50. You know, maybe we should have just pushed through and put it out as Thin Lizzy. But came up with a new name, Black Star Riders. And so basically Lizzy morphed into Black Star Riders. We signed with some great people at Nuclear Blast, the great hard rock and metal label, and gave it 100% focus and put out a really solid first album that was fully embraced by the Thin Lizzy fan base. We wouldn't have gotten us record number two without that fan base.
Right.
But, you know, we were embraced by the very important Classic Rock magazine. You know, all those folks, man, they loved the record because they were very not sure. Like, oh, my God, it's going to be really easy to screw this up.
Yeah.
And I remember those guys coming to a Thin Lizzy show. It was like one of the last shows we were going to perform as Thin Lizzy. We were going to transition to Black Star Riders. And I played some of the songs for, Paul Elliott. Yes, Paul Elliott from Classic Rock Magazine came. And I just played them for him on my computer, on the laptop. And I played him the first song. And about, you know, 60 seconds into it, he just like goes, oh, like this. And I said, is everything cool? He goes, oh man, I'm just relieved. He goes, this is really good. He goes, I was afraid it was gonna not be good and then I would have to lie to you and tell you. Johnny Wong keeps trying to get it right. Way down in Circleville tonight. When darkness falls in the neon lights, it feels like walking dynamite.
You have a couple fans here. I used to tell Dave, I would come in and I'd be like, this is Bam. And I think it's before you and I had met.
I'm sure it was.
And I was like, I don't know how to steal this band. But I was like, I really like this record. I don't know if anybody really knows who it is, but it's really freaking good.
Yeah.
Hey, remember, where did we meet? At that Slash Derek Holmes thing?
No, I'd already met. I was trying to think. Oh, was.
We met at I think Tesla was playing with Leopard at Bridgestone.
Backstage at
Tesla. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah.
the first place.
Is that the first place we met? Yeah. And then again when with Slash and those guys. I think I just remember coming on the tour bus and seeing you.
Yeah.
And us going, hey, you're that guy.
Yeah.
Because Linda was with you, I think.
That's right.
That's you, right?
Right.
And of course, Troy and everybody.
And you were so nice.
I was?
You were.
And yeah, Dave was back. But Dave was back at that show, too.
Yeah. Well, I remember you were at the Slash at the Exit Inn when
yeah, went from St. Helens. He was at the Def Leppard show too.
Well, I'll tell you this, man. Yeah. You guys made an impression on Linda, who any of my musician buddies that might hear this, they know, dude, Linda does not suffer fools. She is, man, she keeps me in line and she can read a person just like that. And there's been so many times, you know, we've left some event and I'd be like, oh, that guy was cool. She goes, mm-mm, no. I'm like, what? And then come to find out, like a few weeks later,
the dude was not cool.
Yeah, he would do something. You'd be like, oh my God, you were right. That guy's not cool. She loved you guys. No. She loved you guys. It's like we got in a car after that. And she goes, yeah, who are those people? I'm like, yeah, they were super cool. So you passed the Linda Johnson test early on. Right, so here we are.
We wouldn't be here if we hadn't.
That's right. You would not.
That's right.